Hello guys, what is up? The Chuckity Chuck here. And today, I have an interesting topic for you. It's quite a sad day in the world of YouTube gaming and the YouTube community in general. I'm not sure if any of you know, but Hutch has obviously left Machinima now, and I wanted to give you my thoughts on it. Obviously, we don't know the ins and outs of why he left, but obviously, he feels he's had enough of the whole YouTube celebrity thing, and he wants to sort of start afresh, I guess. Now, my personal experience when, like, I've never spoke to Hutch or played in a game with him or whatever, but he was probably the first commentator I watched and the one that inspired me to start commentating. He always produced quality videos, always seemed like a really nice guy, and sort of invited us into his life, and I think it's a real credit, because most of the people now, when they commentate, they're in it for the wrong reasons. They don't do it to enjoy the game or to share their experience, help other people out online. They do it for the money mostly, I think. And I'm not sure if he's still going to be uploading. I think in the Machinima video he did, to say goodbye, he said it's highly unlikely that he'll be doing videos. So it's going to be very sad. I think he'll miss it as well, but I guess he's just come to that stage where he's had enough. I mean, I know if I was in his position, living in LA, I mean, I've never been to LA before. I've been to Florida, but obviously it's totally different. Maybe he didn't like the city, got bored with the job, I don't know. It seems like a dream job to me, so he must have really been thinking about this quite hard for quite a long time. And it must have been quite tough to make his decision to leave, because it's hard to describe. It's like Tom Cruise suddenly saying he wants to stop acting and he gets a, like, sex change or whatever. Maybe that's a bit dramatic, but if Hutch never comes back and he totally decides to stop commentating, stop tweeting from his Twitter account, then we'll be losing a member of our society, the founder of our YouTube community. I think it's going to be very difficult, especially, I mean, we all knew one day that these people are going to stop doing it, because they're not going to be 70 and commentating over Call of Duty videos, let's face it, but it's quite a shock really, it came out of the blue, and I'd like to wish him luck in whatever he does, because as I say, who's my inspiration for starting this, so I owe him a great deal of thanks. The one thing I would like to know is why he decides to leave all of a sudden. He must have something lined up, because you can't just leave to no job. He must have been thinking about this for a long, long time. I guess it's very difficult to know without actually talking to him, but I'm sure in the future he'll either go on like Painkiller already or a gaming podcast and they'll explain his reasons behind it. It would be quite strange to think maybe he might start a new YouTube account and not make videos, but he might comment on videos and still watch them. It'll be just like one of us and we won't know if it's him or not. It's going to be very strange to think that Hutch isn't going to do it. And one day, when, I don't know, C-Nanners has enough, I mean, it's already looking as if he's not going to last very long, because I think he goes into it like twice a week or something, so it's obviously not all it's cracked up to be. And Tabe's making like one video every 2 weeks now. I feel like the community's slowly, very slowly dying. A lot of people are losing interest, moving on to other things. I think Woody's gamertag has kind of moved on to be the top dog now, along with Syndicate, although he does more Minecraft stuff. FPS Rusher obviously does the like real life gun stuff, so I guess Woody's gamertag is the number one guy around at the moment. And as I said before, it's going to be very weird to think Hutch isn't going to be making videos anymore. I'm not sure if it's going to sink in for a while. I know this might sound a little bit sad, but I kind of admired him, the way he started off. He had no intention to do YouTube for money. He'd shit to help other people out, just as a hobby, and it led to something great. And I remember when he first got offered the job at Machinima, how happy he was and excited he was. And there's never been any sign on the Machinima videos that he's bored of it. He always seems to be laughing. So I definitely don't think he's leaving Machinima on a sour note. He'll still probably be in touch with everyone that works there. He might even pop in from time to time. Who knows, but I hope he keeps us updated with what he does, because he deserves our full support in whatever he decides to do. He's kind of the god of the YouTube community. And yeah, although he didn't make many videos to his private channel, that isn't me crying, by the way. I have blocked nose. Sorry. although he didn't upload a lot of videos to his own channel, he always tweeted. He always helped out a lot of people from the start. There isn't really anyone about now, apart from maybe Wings of Redemption. He does a lot of shout out, but does things like Quality Time with Hutch, or Camping with Hutch, as it used to be called. I forget what it's called now. Where he gives the smaller channels a shout out, and I think the community needs someone like that, to be honest. But now Hutch is gone, C-Nanners doesn't do Call of Duty anymore, as I say, Tape's doing one video every 2 weeks, so I honestly can't see all this lasting. I think it's got 3-4 years left, maybe. If after 4 years Hutch gets tired and he retires from his, like, once in a lifetime opportunity of a job at Machinima, then I can't see the YouTube community, especially for Call of Duty, lasting that long, whenever it's going to be around forever. But that's my opinion on it, guys. Leave me feedback in the comments, and yeah, good luck to Hutch.